In this video, I will explain the difference between Alpha Lock, Clipping Mask, and Mask in Procreate. I will make a simple watermelon drawing to show you how and when to use each of them. If you will find this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe. Okay, so let's draw a simple triangle shape for a watermelon. Let's fill this inside with our color. Now, if we want to draw a light green skin on our watermelon, we can try to draw it on the same layer as the red shape. We have to change the color and just try to draw it precisely where it should be. But sometimes it's not easy to draw it in the same shape as the red shape. If we want to have our green lines only within the red shape, we can set this layer to be Alpha Lock. We can tap on this layer and here pick Alpha Lock. Now, as you can see, we can draw only within that red shape. You can't draw outside of it. Let's finish drawing the skin. And with Alpha Lock, there is one problem. You can't just drag and drop the color in there. It will affect the whole red shape. So if you want to color that green shape, you have to do it manually. Okay, let's undo it. And let's say we want to draw it with a different brush. This 4B compressed charcoal brush. We can make it bigger and then just draw our skin like this. That looks nice. But now let's say we actually want this skin to be sharper in the place where it connects with the red part of watermelon. So we can take the razor. And as you can see here, it erases everything, because this is all just one layer. Okay, let's go back. And here, in my opinion, it's better to use clipping mask, which will give you more freedom in drawing. So let's go to the layers. And first we are going to turn off Alpha Lock here. And now let's create a new layer above it. Now we can tap on it and set it as clipping mask. With clipping mask, we can still only draw within the red shape. I can draw outside of it, but you won't see it. Now, if I want to erase this light green color, I can do it without destroying my red shape. If I want, I can also move the green shape, use any adjustments on it, or even delete it if I don't like it. But now, I would like to add some darker green colors to the watermelon skin. So for this, I am going to set this layer to Alpha Lock, so I can draw only within that light green shape. I'm taking a new color, and I'm just adding some shading here. In this case, I know that I will not be changing enough this later. I hope it will make sense to you. Let's take one more green color and draw it at the skin's edge. Now I would like to add some seeds to this watermelon, and I don't want to draw them on the red shape because I would feel better knowing that I can change them later if I have to. So for this I will make a new layer and I will set it as clipping mask. Even though this is not exactly above the layer of the red shape, it has the other clipping mask underneath it, and because of that this layer will also be clipped to the red shape one. So let's take a new color for drawing watermelon seeds. And I'm going to change the brush for this to Studio Pen from Inking. Let's draw simple shapes like this. Because this is a clipping mask, I can draw here on the edge easily without worrying that I will go outside of this red shape. Now let's add some shadows and lights under those seeds. It will look nicer this way. Let's open the layers. The shadows should be under the seeds layer, but above the red shape. So let's tap on the layer of the red shape and create a new layer above it. As you can see, it already sets itself as a clipping mask. Okay, so let's take this light red color and let's change the brush to wine charcoal from charcoals. And I'm just going to add some light on the left side of each seed. Now let's get the darker red color and draw of it on the right side of each seed. Because those shadows and seeds are on separate clipping mask layers and not on the red shape layer set as alpha lock, if I want to, I could now move them easily or erase, let's say, one of the seeds. Now I would like to add some texture to the red shape, and I could make one more layer and set it to clipping mask, but for this I actually think I will be just fine with making the red shape layer as alpha lock and drawing on that layer. I'm just going to change the brush size and opacity and loosely draw on the red shape. Now same with the light red color, and in a moment I will explain you what this mask and how you can use it. Okay, so now let's say we would like to make this watermelon look like it was bitten. One way, of course, would be just using the eraser, but we can also use a mask, which is a better option, and I will show you why. So let's tap on this red shape layer, and here we have a mask option. If we tap on it, it will appear as a separate mask layer here. And this mask layer works like this, that if we take a black color, we can take away some part of our red shape. But keep in mind that we are not erasing it. It is still there, but we are just only masking it, so it's not visible. If we took, let's say, a gray color instead of the black, it would also work this way, but it would give us not the full opacity in taking the color away. We could still see some red color. Okay, now let's say we look at this watermelon and we decide we want this bitten part to be smaller. We took away too much. Because we are using the mask, it's not a problem. We can just now take white color and bring back our red shape. And here is my finished watermelon. I hope this video was useful and helped you understand alpha lock, clipping mask and mask. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more content like this, please like this video and subscribe. Thank you for watching and see you in my next video. Bye!